Hi, welcome to this webinar with ComApp and with me, Sophie Kellogagnon. I suggest to talk today about the AutoSAR. AutoSAR, it's the ComApp auto-balancing valve. It's also the technology for the dynamic balancing. So about this presentation, first I suggest to talk about the variable flow rate issue, so the variable flow rate in the heating installation, two solutions regarding the dynamic balancing, and a third solution about the AutoSAR. At the end of this presentation, I'm going to explain the AutoSAR benefits and to finish the presentation, a numerical conclusion. So let's talk about the variable flow rate in the heating network. So the studied case, so it's in order to give you some figures about a specific case. So here it's a residential building. It's an eight-story building. There is a collective boiler, and the boiler is situated at the basement, in the basement. We are interested in the heating network, and the heating network is made of four risers. All the branches are the same. There is one apartment per branch, and all apartments are the same. That means we need the same flow rate through the installation, through the heating network. It's in order to make the calculation easy. So first, when there is a new network, it's necessary to do the static balancing. So that means on every branch, there is a static balancing valve. Here it's a ComApp 750 valve. And you can also see the sitting position, so the position of the valve. So at the most resistive circuit, so flow number 8, the position is 40, that means the valve is fully open. And at the less resistive circuit, the valve position is 29, 29, that means 75% open. There is also a static balancing valve at the bottom of the riser. In that case, when the valve is adjusted, that means the flow rates through the branches are adjusted. So the flow rate is 330 liters per hour. And with this flow rate, the temperature is comfortable everywhere at every flow, and the temperature is 20 degrees. So 330 liters per hour is the nominal flow rate per branch. So in that case, it works well when the network is operating at its designed power. So for example, in January, when the weather is cold, when everybody needs to heat their apartment at its designed power, so there is no sun outside. Now let's talk about the variable flow rate through the installation. Imagine it's a sunny day in January, and there is the sun heat contribution, so some thermostatic valves close, in that case in four apartments. And so four branches are off. Of course, there is an overflow, and the delta P is increasing where the valves are open. And if the delta P is increasing, that means there is an overflow in the branches, so through the branches that work. Of course, when the delta P is increasing, the pump is going to adapt to the situation, and the pump speed is going to decrease. But the pump can't see what happens very far from itself. So that's why the delta P is increasing. And of course, there is an overflow. In our case, in our studied case, For example, level 8, instead of having 330 liters per hour per branch, in the branch, through the branch, the flow rate is 397 liters per hour. So the flow is 20% higher. And for the less resistive circuit, so flow number one, the flow rate is now 434 liters per hour. That means the flow is 34% higher. And of course, the temperature is increasing in the apartment. So that means that the static balancing is not suitable when there is a variable flow rate in the installation. The issue is that it's 80% of time. So the static balancing is not suitable. It's not enough. We need a dynamic balancing. So we must add a dynamic balancing in order to control the flow rate. As a conclusion for this part of this presentation, so the consequences when there is a variable flow rate in the installation. So when the thermostatic valves close and when there is an overflow through the radiators, there is no thermal comfort anymore because if there is an overflow, the temperature is going to increase, so it's not comfortable. There is no acoustic comfort anymore because if there is an overflow, the speed velocity is increasing and it may lead to noise. And regarding the energy efficiency, so it's not efficient anymore because there is an overflow, so it's energy consuming. And the return temperature is not as expected. It's going to be higher than expected. So for the condensation boiler, it's not suitable at all. So the solution is to add dynamic balancing. So now let's talk about two solutions of dynamic balancing. So in our studied case, we said that we don't want to have overflows through the radiators. As a result, that means we don't want overflows through the branches and we don't want overflows through the risers. To avoid overflows, we have to avoid the delta P to increase through the branches and through the emitters. So the delta P must not be exceeded. In order to achieve this result, we need a delta P controller. And for COMAP, the delta P controller, it's the Nexus valve PASIM. So now, first solution, the dynamic balancing of the riser. The delta P controller is installed at the bottom of the riser with the partner valve. And for the branches, we can add static balancing valves. The data for the setting in that case, so the delta P that we are going to adjust through the risers is through this riser is 19 kPa. And when we adjust 19 kPa through the delta P controller, we are going to adjust at the same time the flow rate through the riser, so 2,640 liters per hour. The valve dimension is the same as the pipe dimension, in that case, the N40. That's a first solution, and in that case, even if there is a variable flow in the installation, the flow, the nominal flow, so 330 liters per hour per branch, won't be exceeded, and the temperature is still comfortable. The temperature is 20 degrees. Another solution, it's the dynamic balancing of the branches. So now, the purpose is to install delta P controllers on the branches. It's better than the other solution because the delta P controller is closer to the emitter. When we want to control an emitter, a radiator, for example, it's better to control it closest to the radiator. It's the best way to control the emitter. So as in that case, we are closer to the emitter, it works better than the last solution. For the riser, we are going to add a static balancing valve in order to do the static balancing of the risers. In that case, it works well. The nominal flow won't be exceeded, and the nominal flow is 330 liters per hour with the temperature equal to 20 degrees. The other solution is the AutoSAR solution. So the AutoSAR, you can see a cut of the project on the screen. The AutoSAR, it's an auto-balancing valve. So it's a thermostatic valve and with a flow limiter inside. So there is a blue cap. The blue cap, it's a way to know for COMAP to know that we are talking about auto-balancing valve. It's a thermostatic valve, so there is a needle and a spring. The piece of equipment in gray is the piece of equipment to adjust the nominal flow, so to adjust the KV value on the AutoSAR. So it's a preset KV valve, the seat, and the flow limiter. So the flow limiter, that means we are going to adjust 66 liter per hour. It's the nominal flow for the radiator. And this nominal flow won't be exceeded when the delta P across the AutoSAR is between 10 and 60 kPa. Let's talk about our studied case. So we said that there is one apartment per branch. So for the last branch, for example, there are five radiators. So for the apartment, and here another example for the floor number one and floor number two, still five radiators per apartment. It's the same network. Because it's easier for the calculation. And all the radiators have 66 liters per hour for the nominal flow. The idea is to install an AutoSAR on each radiator. And in that way, it's the flow rate is controlled nearest to the radiator, so it's the most efficient solution. We also install a static valve at the bottom of the riser. Why? It's possible that depending on the network, so the architecture of the network, it may be necessary to add a static valve at the bottom of the riser. Even if it's not necessary, it's better to install what? To install a valve. Why? We need a ball valve. We need a stop valve at the bottom of the riser. Instead of installing a stop valve, it's better to install a balancing valve because with the balancing valve, we have the function stop valve. And we also have two other functions. First, the diagnostic function, because there are two pressure ports on the valve, so it's possible to measure the flow rate when the network is operating. And it's also possible to drain the network from the balancing valve. So instead of installing only a stop valve, it's better to install a valve with some added values. In that case, diagnostic and draining. So the results with AutoSAR. We said that there is an AutoSAR on every radiator. At the most resistive circuit, it's necessary to adjust the delta P across the AutoSAR in order to have at least 10 kPa. So that is a part of the job of the pump. So we are going to adjust the pump in order to have 10 kPa across the AutoSAR. For the other AutoSAR, so for the other floors, of course, the circuit has less resistive, so the delta P through the AutoSAR will be higher. And we can see that for the less resistive circuit, the delta P across the AutoSAR is 15 kPa. It's below 60 kPa, so it's okay, it's going to work well. Don't forget that for the AutoSAR, it's necessary to adjust the nominal flow. In that case, the nominal flow through the radiator is 66 liters per hour. And this flow won't be exceeded in the case if some AutoSARs close. So let's talk now about the variable flow rate through the installation. So imagine it's a sunny day, the sun is shining, there is some heat, heat contribution to the apartment, so some thermostatic valves, so some AutoSAR close, and the delta P increases across the AutoSAR that are open. The delta P so increases, and we can see that for the less resistive circuit, the delta P across the AutoSAR was 15 kPa, and it's becoming 24 kPa. So as the delta P is still below 60 kPa, that means the AutoSAR can control the water flow rate and the temperature remain comfortable. So the nominal flow won't be exceeded and the temperature is still the same, that means 20 degrees. So that's the result with the AutoSAR. And that's the most efficient solution because the AutoSAR is directly connected to the radiator and the AutoSAR controls the flow rate through the radiator. Let's talk now about the Comar the AutoSAR benefits. First, regarding the product itself, the accuracy. It's very important to have a product which can accurately control the flow rate. On the chart here, you can see a comparison between four auto-balancing valves in the market. For the x-axis, there is the delta P across the auto-balancing valve. So from 0.1 bar to 0.6 bar, or 10 to 60 kPa. And for the y-axis, it's the flow rate in liter per hour. You can see that two products don't control the flow rate below 0.3 bar or 30 kPa. And so the two products are not suitable for the small collective building. And for the green curve here, you can see that the product doesn't control the flow rate when the delta P is above 30 kPa. So it's not suitable for the big residential building. Only AutoSAR is suitable for all these applications because the flow rate is accurately controlled. The other feature which is important is the robustness of the product. The product has to control the flow rate over time. In the case of AutoSAR, the information about the delta P is given by the membrane you can see here. And on the screen, you can see on the cut here of the AutoSAR, you can see the water running across the AutoSAR. In this situation, it's unlikely that some particles from the water come onto the membrane or under the membrane. So we can say that the membrane is going to give the information, the delta P information over time, and the product is going to control the flow rate over time. So pay attention to these two important features, the accuracy and the robustness of the product. The benefits now regarding the cost reduction. In the case of dynamic balancing and regarding AutoSAR, we need less balancing valves. So it's cheaper regarding the products. It's quicker and cheaper regarding the commissioning. We have to adjust the flow rate across the AutoSAR, as we have to adjust the flow rate across a thermostatic valve. So it's the same job, but it's easier with AutoSAR because the key to adjust the flow rate is graduated in liter per hour directly, so it's easier. And as we said, there are less balancing valves, so it's quicker and cheaper to commission. There is no over energy consumption because there is no overflow, so it's we can save money regarding the over consumption. The return temperature, so the return temperature is fixed and is as expected for the condensation boiler, so it's an optimization. And there is no early wear because there is no overflow, so the speed, the water velocity is as expected, so there is no early wear of the installation, so it's better regarding the sustainability of the installation. So for all that reasons, it's money saving to install AutoSAR. The other benefit is regarding the comfort. So as the temperature is accurately controlled, it's comfortable. And as the there is no overflow, so the water velocity is as expected, so there is no noisy, so it's also comfortable. Let's talk now about numerical conclusions. So I'm going to give you some figures to show that the AutoSAR solution is very interesting. So the comparison is from a software, iSOPT. So iSOPT is a solution for the design offices to select the best solution regarding the energy consumption for the building. And here there is a comparison between an auto-balancing valves, the auto-balancing valves, so a network with auto-balancing valves and the same network with thermostatic valves, preset KV valves or fixed KV valves. And with the auto-balancing valves, we can say that 14% of the pump energy is saving, 9% of the global energy is saving, 8% is saving regarding the invoice. If the heating water is produced by a heat pump and a boiler, the heat pump contribution is 7% higher. That means we less use the boiler, and if we less use the boiler, the carbon impact is reduced, is 8% reduced. So that's the end of this presentation. These figures are very interesting. It's the most efficient solution regarding the energy consumption, so regarding the balancing of the installation. This presentation is finished now. Thank you for attending it. You can join us on CoExpert. You can join us on the social media. See you later for another webinar. Have a nice day and bye-bye.